the Jose Esteban Muñoz Award presented to Jose Antonio Vargas for his community leadership, advocacy, and promotion of LGBTQ studies by CLAGS.
New York Center for LGBTQ Studies, or CLAGS, honored Jose Antonio Vargas with a 2016 Jose Esteban Award for being a leader in the field of queer studies Tuesday. CLAGS is the first university-based LGBTQ research center in the U.S. The event was also a conversation with a Pulitzer Prize-winning and Emmy-nominated filmmaker about Pride Month, Orlando Gay Nightclub mass shooting, and the 2016 presidential election.
I invited Donald Trump to come.
Yeah.
You know, I've been trying to get an interview with Donald Trump. I figured if he was going to try to win the White House on the back of all this misinformation and bigotry about immigration, at least he should talk to us about it. Unfortunately, he just hasn't had the courage.
Vargas says Trump's recent campaign shakeup and financial woos do not necessarily mean it's the end of the road for Trump.
I actually do not think we should underestimate that Donald Trump could possibly win this election. We should not underestimate this. White people are very, very, very energized in the first reality television election we've ever had. It's like watching The Real Housewives meets The Apprentice, like all in once.
5 years ago today, Vargas came out as an undocumented immigrant via a New York Times article. He also publicly came out as gay.
The biggest thing I have to say is, you know, earning my privilege, right? Like, you're looking at the most privileged undocumented immigrant in America. I am. So I have to own that. I have to own what that means without, you know, punishing myself too much for it. And trying to make sure that I speak in the most authentic and organic way that I can.
Meanwhile, the recent Orlando gay nightclub shooting that killed 49 people gave Pride Month a new meaning. A push for a safer gun policy is expected during the NYC Pride Parade on Sunday. The Human Rights Campaign, one of the most successful lobbying groups in the U.S., has declared war on NRA last Friday.
Unfortunately, this is kind of an example, you know, that people needed in order to move them. I think the conversations that are happening now around what safety means, you know, that we're looking at gun control, but we're talking about it through a lens of terrorism.
In the wake of the Orlando tragedy, organizers say the Pride Parade in New York City will continue as planned on Sunday, while the NYPD will help ensure the safety of the millions of marchers and spectators. Their reason? To never allow those who wish to silence the LGBTQ community win. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.